Well, we learned the U.S. request to delay deep water drilling has been denied. Our Lizzie O'Leary has been in the Gulf giving us a firsthand account of this disaster for over a month now. Right now, she comes to us from New Orleans. And Lizzie, what does this denial mean?
Well, so essentially what this means is that Judge Martin Feldman, who is the judge who issued this order basically overturning the ban, has granted an emergency hearing. He's denying the ability of the federal government to delay this lifting right now, but to expedite the hearing here in New Orleans. Judge Feldman, of course, has come under some fire for having some personal investments in oil and gas companies, according to his most recent financial disclosures. We don't know the current situation because those date back to 2008, but it's very important to note that this is part of this legal volley that's going back and forth between the folks who sued to get this moratorium lifted, a consortium of about 12 offshore and onshore oil companies, and the federal government. The next stop could be the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals, and that's here in New Orleans as well. Now, this, of course, is all happening while the oil spill is reaching further east than it has in quite some time. Fairly dramatic pictures of oil washing up on the beaches in Pensacola, Florida. We were there last week, and you really didn't see much oil except way out in the water. Now it's coming onto those white sand beaches. Also, as BP has finally reinstalled its containment cap on the leaking wellhead. And essentially, they removed it because we saw some fluids, some potential hydrates moving up in the line toward the surface. So they took the cap off, and now they've put it back on, guys.
Lizzie, in terms of this, there not being a delay here on the moratorium being lifted, so does that mean drilling is going to begin again pretty much immediately on the existing rigs that are in the Gulf? And are we going to see, there were some that were just preparing to drill, are we going to see all of that going forward right away?
I think that's a very hard question to answer. There's so much legal uncertainty around this. One of the things you hear from people down here is that the legal uncertainty is almost akin to the moratorium because this is changing rapidly in the court system. These rigs, of course, run about $500,000 a day to operate, and the moratorium had some companies. I talked to Anadarko. They had basically canceled their contracts on three of their rigs out in the Gulf, basically three of those 33, because of the moratorium. I think the ongoing legal aspects of this, when you talk to people here, they say that's still too much uncertainty until they know what course this is going to take in the courts. And traditionally, even with a fast track, a Fifth Circuit appeal would run somewhere in the 6 to 9 month range.